Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner, and I am available for code reviews and on-site training. Now, before I get started with this episode, I do want to remind you that I will be giving a workshop on C++ best practices at NDC Tech Town in early September 2024 in Kongsberg, Norway. So if you're in Europe and have any interest in attending one of my classes, perhaps you haven't been able to attend one because you were not able to get me to your company, then be sure to check out this workshop. Okay, in this episode, I want to talk about using span and string view safely. This function has undefined behavior, and the compiler compiles it. And up to this point, we probably don't see any warnings at all from our compiler. Now, there has been some recent movement in Clang to catch lifetime issues. So let's see if the latest version of Clang with all the warnings enabled is able to catch anything here. Now, I did enable -w everything with Clang, which gives me all of these rather annoying C++ 98 compatibility things. Ah, here we go. Address of stack memory associated with local variable result returned here. So we do get a warning from Clang. And this is the part that we really want to be aware of. This address of stack memory associated with a local variable result returned. And we're getting nothing from GCC. Let's turn both of these on execute. They are on execute, execute. Okay. So we aren't actually using this bad memory. Now I need to step back and point out what the actual bug is. I am creating a standard string, which is going to do a heap allocation. And then I am returning this string as a result. But the thing that I'm returning is a string view. And all a string view is literally a view to a string-like thing. So this object, SV, that I have on line 10, now points to memory that has been freed because the standard string is going to automatically free its underlying data on line 6 of this function when result is popped from the stack. And this is where we have our undefined behavior. Now, we haven't actually observed this undefined behavior yet because we're not trying to actually print the string out. So let's go ahead and do that. And we can see this gobbledygook that has been printed from Clang, and GCC has similar meaningless data here. I get the warnings from Clang. That's good. I don't get warnings from GCC. Now I've just gone and turned on address sanitizer. And we can see that I get an address sanitizer crash in both cases where it tells me memory that was allocated on the stack in this certain point on get data on line 7 was freed. And then I'm using that data on line 12, basically. And I'm going to get a similar output from both of my tools here. So let's go ahead and do a quick overview of what the problem is. So string view and similarly span, I don't even need to give an example of how span can do the same thing because it's the same basic idea. I can return a span and have a vector that I'm returning. They are pointers to other data that exist. It's possible and relatively easy to create views that outlive the underlying data. And this causes the UB that we're talking about. UB is undefined behavior. I am going to rant for a moment about how implicit conversions are evil, and this comes up over and over again on this channel. We have an implicit conversion from string to string view, therefore it is easy to accidentally do this. Oops, maybe our standard library should not have provided that implicit conversion from string to string view. Okay. So there is a couple of fixes here. First, turn on all of your compiler warnings. It's possible that Clang today can catch this. And the second is to use address sanitizer when running your test. The thing about this kind of problem is that a lot of people in the C++ community say, I can't use string view or recommend it to people because it is too easy to have this kind of undefined behavior. My counter to that is that if you use address sanitizer to test this code, then it's like really very easy to catch the bug. Address sanitizer catches this kind of use after free 100% of the time and trivially. So you need address sanitizer if you're using things like string views or realistically references or reference wrapper or span or pointers anywhere in your code, which is basically all C++ code. So use address sanitizer and catch these things. And then the other thing I might say is const expir all the things here, which might seem a little perhaps trite or something. But if I make this const expir, then I am going to find myself doing something like this and returning perhaps just the string itself. And this is 100% valid defined behavior because I have a const character literal, which is guaranteed to live for the lifetime of the program. I can create a const expir string view of it. So I need const expir here as well to really get the point across. And then I know that I am always going to have something that is guaranteed to live for the lifetime of the program. And then we might even go the extra step of making this const eval and say this thing must always be evaluated at compile time, and that eliminates the potential hypothetical overhead of constructing the string view at runtime from the compile time known const character literal. So those are the main things. All the compiler warnings, use address sanitizer, const expir all the things, and... So let's go ahead and make a quick const expir test here to prove my point. Okay, so note that this code compiles and we catch it with address sanitizer later. Now, if I make it const expir, then I should get a compile failure now. Error: const expir variable must be initialized by a constant expression. Oh, and I got an internal compiler error basically from GCC, but I'm using trunk. It's not a release version. So the point being, if I make a const expir assignment of this thing or in some other way try to use it at compile time, then that's going to get caught by the compiler at compile time. And we certainly can't do this with everything, but we can do it with a lot of things in our code. So consider that const expir doesn't allow undefined behavior. So it's a good tool for catching undefined behavior when you can construct const expir values. All right, that's enough for this episode. The point being, if you really want to use string view or span safely, you need to use address sanitizer and lean more heavily on const expir. But this also applies to pointers, references, and reference wrapper, which are all sneaky ways of creating references and pointers to things that might be destroyed out from underneath us. Not necessarily sneaky, but you get my point here. So anyhow, thanks for watching this episode. Be sure to subscribe.